All right, what's up everyone? Today I'm gonna try to do something a little bit different than I usually do. I'm gonna try to quantify exactly how much benefit I get out of insulating these PEX lines that are in the basement. So if you haven't watched my central boiler video, I'll put a link up here in the right-hand corner. Go over there and check out the central boiler video. If you haven't seen it yet, I have an outdoor wood furnace that feeds into my heat exchanger in my furnace so that when the house calls for heat, the fan blows heat over my water to air exchanger, and that is heated outside by the outdoor wood furnace. So the only place that my lines are not insulated whatsoever is inside here in the basement. And so what I'm going to do is measure and take an average of exactly what temperature every vent is getting in the house. So I can take an overall average of the vent temperature in my house, and then I'm gonna go through and insulate all of these PEX pipes. And I'm gonna insulate them from here all the way back to the wall where they terminate. I'm gonna wrap them in just regular foam like you would insulate any other pipe. And then I'm going to go back through and I'm going to take my average again of all of the registers in the house. Now, the only way that this can be constant is if my burner outside is at 195 degrees. So I'm gonna measure it at 195 degrees. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to go out there and monitor it. When the temperature reaches 195 degrees out there, I will start my test. And then I will make sure that it's on the cool down cycle so that it's not on a heating cycle. It'll be on a cool down cycle out there. So 195, and then it'll take the same amount of time for me to go from register to register and figure out my temps and average them out. So I'll wait until it gets to 195, do my measurements, wrap the pipes, wait till it gets to 195, do my measurements again, so that we can keep as much as possible constant in this situation, so that I can legitimately quantify if it's worth insulating these pipes inside the house. Now, it stays about 80 degrees down here in this utility room because I am getting a lot of radiant heat off of my PEX pipes, and I also have a vent directly overhead that heats a lot of this area too, and I keep it wide open. So it keeps it very, very warm down here in the utility room. But this video is just purely to quantify exactly whether or not it's worth it to wrap my pipes in PEX, to wrap my pipes in insulation, and if it makes a difference or not. So I always am about putting actual numbers and results to my work, so we're gonna try it out. Follow along. I'm not gonna make this a very long video. We're gonna average our temps, and then we're gonna have a short discussion about it, whether or not it's worth it. So here we go. All right, so I've already taken my temperatures on the first go round. So I will explain at the end of the video exactly all the variables and how I thought about them and how I tried to control them as much as possible. I haven't done my average yet on the temperatures, but this is what I'm going to do. I am going to go crazy on insulating every single inch of this pipe in here. I'm thinking about even wrapping the thermostatic valve in insulation, batten insulation, and probably this heat exchanger on the side of my water heater. I'm gonna try to wrap it as much as possible. So I'm gonna go absolutely crazy with insulating all the pipes in here and get a little wild with it, where it might not look that pretty, but I'm gonna make sure it's all insulated and it's contained as much as possible. If we see a quantifiable difference in the second test, then I will look at maybe scaling that back just a little bit, but keeping most of that insulation in there. If I don't see a quantifiable difference, then it's all gonna come off and I'm not going to use it. I might keep the insulation on the pipes, but at that point, is it really worth it? So the insulation, the foam insulation, all I'm doing is using the foam insulation that you can buy in the box. It's the pre-slit polyurethane pipe insulation. So literally that's all I'm using for around the pipes, around all the valves and all that stuff. I'm probably gonna do batten insulation and figure out a way to wrap it, maybe duct tape it, just go crazy with it. And then if we truly see a difference, then I know that, you know, it's worth finding another option that is a little bit more aesthetically pleasing. So we're gonna cut frame and I'm gonna go through and insulate this stuff, and we'll see exactly what it does on the next test. So stay tuned.
All right, so I've gone through and insulated every inch of my pipes. So the last thing I have left to do is put a little bit of insulation around my three-way zone valve and tape the rest of this stuff off. So I put some of the insulated flexible duct, as I'm talking about it, I'll cut in some frames for you to see the insulated duct. Basically, it's the soft ducting. I just basically took out the inside of it and sliced down the side so that I could wrap it around pipe. So I wrapped my entire thermostatic valve here and everything coming in from the wall since it was really close. From here back to the furnace, I'm only really worried about one pipe, so it didn't make sense to take the batten insulation and the insulation duct tube and bring it all the way down here. But I've completely insulated this. I'm gonna finish taping this up and making it as tight as I can get it, and then we're gonna go through and retest and see exactly if there's a quantifiable difference between this insulation and not having it whatsoever. So, well, stay tuned.
All right, everybody, so we're back. So, went through and insulated all these pipes. I went above and beyond in a lot of areas doing the insulation ducting, plus the foam plastic, or the foam cover on the pipes. So I went above and beyond with this. I got some interesting results. So I tried to keep the test as constant as possible in all variables other than the temperature coming out of the vent. The unit that I used was a cooking thermometer, a true temp cooking thermometer. I'll put a link in the description of the one I used, and I'll also include a picture right now. Okay, I used this cooking thermometer. I dangled it in the vent in the exact same place in all of the vents, making sure that it did not come in contact with the metal piping, and also that I had the vent completely open so there was complete airflow and it wasn't like it was the end of the line and I just had it closed just for the thermometer in there. So I only had one measurement that didn't make sense. On vent number 4, I went from the furthest vent from the furnace to around the main floor, on my first floor, around the main floor, all the way around to the closest vent. So naturally, the furthest vent was the coolest, and the closest vent was the hottest. So then I averaged them all together. On my first run, I had 117 degrees as my average temp. Now I had a kind of weird reading on vent 4. It read at 113 degrees for some reason. It went 115, 116, 119, 113. Being closer to the furnace, I was thinking that that was an erroneous reading, but I did it twice there and it was the same both times. So I'm not exactly sure maybe how the vent work goes. That didn't make sense and it just was a little colder. So I thought something was fishy there, but turns out on the second time around when I came back with all of the insulated pipe, that was 118. So it had gone up 5 degrees. So I think that that was a little skewed there in the first test, which means that after all of the insulation and all the work I did, if that was truly an erroneous reading, and I'm thinking that it was, the chart shows and all of the data shows that I actually lost temperature at the vent by insulating these pipes, which doesn't make a lot of sense to me. But if that were to be a reading with, all of my readings before were almost dead on with all of my readings after the insulation. So maybe a 1 degree split. I have one that was the same, one that was 1 degree less, another one that was 1 degree less after I insulated. Then there was that vent 4 that was 5 degrees more, which now skews my average. I had vent 5 at the exact same temperature. I had vent 6 at 1 degree less. And I had vent 7 at the exact same temperature. So if I take out that erroneous line there, that 113 that I got the first time for some reason, then that means that my average vent temp went down with all of the insulating these pipes, theoretically making the heat exchanger hotter. made my vent temp go down. So that is exactly what I found. So if you were to ask me if it was worth insulating the pipes, absolutely not. I'm glad that I did it so that I could see exactly the data and quantify it here on paper. Just so you know, if you really want to get real technical with my test and get down to the nitty gritty, I left my other sheet upstairs, but I warmed the burner up to 195 degrees at the top of her burn cycle. These were hours apart, so I insulated, and a couple hours later, I went back and did the second test. So just let you know that there's plenty of time for heat soak and all of those things to come into play. So I made sure that I did that. I went back out to the burner, ramped it back up to 195, it shut down, and I came back and did my test. Each test was started at the 5 minute mark from when the furnace was kicked on. So I had the furnace off, I took the wood burner up to 195 degrees, I came inside, turned the furnace on, start 5 minute clock. Then I started taking my measurements. The first test was done in 13 minutes and 30 seconds from start to finish, doing all of my temperature probing. The second test was done in 12 minutes and 45 seconds. So I did it a little bit faster, but nonetheless, it was almost the exact same time spent at each vent. So if you really want to quantify that, that's maybe a couple seconds at each vent that I did a little bit less of. But as soon as the temperature gauge came up to and settled on a number, I was done at that vent and we were going on to the next one. So it was anywhere from a minute to a minute and a half at each vent. So as soon as I was done with that, on to the next, and that is exactly what I found. Every single probe location was the same on everything. I used the same probe with a fresh battery. I made sure it was calibrated by boiling water and making sure that it showed 212 degrees. It did all of those things to make sure that my thermometer was spot on, my results were spot on, and everything I was doing with that thermometer was exactly the same. The time limits, the furnace giving time to warm up and actually blow hot air. I let it blow for 5 minutes before I started the test. And without my erroneous, I'm thinking that we're down 2 or 3 degrees. So I don't have a calculator on me right now, but if I took out that erroneous one, it would be down a couple degrees. So what I'll do is I'll include two different pictures. I'll include a picture of what I got first, then we'll line out that erroneous one if we wanted to. I think I was a bad reading the first time around, not sure exactly what happened, but if we line that out, then I'll show you right here data that the temperature went down at my vent because I insulated my pipes. That's kind of crazy. So the only thing that changed in this entire thing was that the burner was 2 degrees warmer when we ended our test. So I started the test at 195 degrees, like I said before. On the first test, it was down to 187 when I was done with my 15-minute test, about. It was about 17 minutes. If you add the 5 minutes plus the 1330, then you get 18 minutes and 30 seconds. So just shy of 20 minutes, it was down to 187 degrees. On my second test, it was down to 189. So that means that the water going back was staying warmer so that it preserved itself a little bit more. But that 2 degree difference in that 20 minute runtime is nothing. That's nothing that I track. I track the heat out of the vents, how well the house warms up. I don't track how well the unit stays up to temperature and how much we use it in here. Based on that 2 degree difference over that 20 minutes, does that even take off one burn cycle through the day? I don't think so. So if you want my opinion, I have quantified exactly what it's like in my house, whether or not it was worth insulating this 30 foot of pipe here, and it's absolutely not. In fact, it made the house perform worse. So that is my take on that. That is my research and my true test that I did. I'll include videos throughout, or pictures throughout the video, and show you exactly what I did and how I did it. And you can make the decision yourself, but if I were to recommend, I'd say don't insulate your pipes. It's not a big deal to have them exposed. It does feel a lot cooler in this utility room just since I've started. and it's been 4 hours, 5 hours since I talked to you last, when I said it's really, really hot in here. So yes, it takes down the ambient temperature in here, but it absolutely does not perform better at the vent, and that's what we're all worried about, is performing better at the vent. So if you like my video, go ahead and subscribe. I'd love to see you guys later on in the channel. Keep your smiling faces around, and I hope to see you next video. If you like, go ahead and comment anything, ask any questions. If you have a variable that I didn't think of, I'd love to hear your opinion and exactly where maybe I could do better. I'm going to take some random tests throughout the next week and see if it did anything, but otherwise I'm going to strip all of this insulation off so it doesn't look so crazy, because it did make a difference. So I've had a lot of insulation contractors in here, and other contractors say you should insulate your pipes. Well, here's the data straight up in your face. Boom, I didn't need to do it. I'm glad I didn't spend any money on this project. I had all of these supplies hanging around from leftover projects. So I didn't spend a dime on this project. I had all of this stuff with here at the house. So I figured I might as well go ahead and do it. And it wasn't worth it. So that's my take on it. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you next video.